Good morning to our lecturer, Dr. Muhammad Ramida bin Ramli, which teaching operating system with subject code BCN2053. Today, we will present our assignment for SEM 2 2019-2020. In this video, we will discuss about Windows 10 operating system and Ubuntu operating system. The year of release of Windows 10 is 2015, while the Ubuntu is 2004.
The evolution of Windows starting from Windows 1 in 1985 to now Windows 10 in 2015. This is the version release of Windows 10. The latest version is 2004.
This figure shows the evolution of Linux system. There are many version release of Ubuntu system due to the free open source of Linux operating system.
I want to talk about the memory management. My name is Kong Chun. My matrix number is CA19108. Number one, memory management, especially on visual memory in Windows 10, is a hidden system file with system extension that is stored on your computer system drive, usually in C drive. The patch file allows the computer to perform smoothly by reducing the workload of the physical memory or RAM. For example, every time you open more application, then the RAM on your PC can accommodate the program already present in the RAM automatically transferred to the patch file. The next system is Ubuntu Linux. The Ubuntu Linux system will determine the amount of free space available with the df command. Number two, the next is Linux can use either a normal file in the file system or a separate partition or swap space. A swap partition is faster, but it is easier to change the size of a swap file. The number two is maximum or minimum memory requirement by each operating system. Windows 10 in 32-byte architecture, minimum memory requirement must 1 GB, maximum memory recognized is 4 GB. In Windows 10 in 64-byte architecture, maximum memory requirement is 2 GB, maximum memory recognized is 512 GB. The next system is Ubuntu Desktop Edition, 32-byte architecture. Minimum memory requirement must 1 GB. Maximum memory requirement must 4 GB. Ubuntu Desktop Edition, 64-byte architecture. Maximum memory requirement is 2 GB. Maximum memory allow is 2^64 GB. Compare the recommend which operating system utilize memory more efficient. Number one is normal usage. In Windows 10, you user account allow you to sign in to Windows 10. Computer already has one user account. When setting Windows for the first time, you can create a separate user account for each member of your home or office. Ubuntu Linux less choice, and it has not come with some important pre-built parental control feature. In Ubuntu, you need third-party application to set up parental control feature. That is track and control the computer usage of your user account. Number two is server usage. In Linux is better than Windows 10 because Linux server and application that run generally use fewer computer resources as they are designed to run LAN. Programmer can modify Linux system and software without reporting. Windows 10 In Windows 10, Microsoft Windows Server tend to slow down under multi-database tasking with a higher risk of crashing.
My name is Leong Wei Chief with the metrics number CA19104. Today I will be presenting the process management. In the first slide, process management is requesting CPU resources. Under Windows 10, there are 6 stages, which is new, ready, running, suspend, block, and exit. In Ubuntu, they will be having 5 stages, which is ready, running, waiting, stop, and zombie. So let's talk about Windows 10 first. Under Windows 10, the new state where the process has been just created but not yet been admitted to the pool of execution of the process by the Windows operating system. After the job has been admitted, the Windows 10 operating system is prepared to take a new job to be executed, which is in the ready state. Then the job is being dispatched to the running state to execute it by the system. However, if there is too many processes at one time to requesting the resources, it will block some of the job until the job in the running state are completed of an I/O operation. When the process in the main memory are in the block state, the operating system can be suspend one processor by putting in suspend state and transferring it to the second memory. This involves the sweeping, which move the part of a process from the main memory to the second memory. When the process is completely running, completely in the running state, some of the processors will then again dispatch to the ready state to be executed after the process has been completed. So after everything is completed, the Windows operating system will release it and exit. So in the Ubuntu operating system, when a process is being added in the operating system, it will be in the ready state to wait for to be executed. Then the task will be dispatched to the running state to be executed. If there are too many processes needed to be executed in one time, Linux will dispatch the system to the waiting state to wait for the resources. However, Linux have two types of waiting process, which is interruptible and uninterruptible. Interruptible waiting process can be interrupted by the signal, whereas uninterruptible waiting process are waiting directly on the hardware condition and cannot be interrupted under any circumference. Then the task is dispatched to the stop stage where the process is being debugged. The task then transferred to the zombie state where is the help process, which for some of the reason is still a task stuck data structure in the task vector. The next slide will be OS affecting with various CPU type. Under Spark CPU in generally is not supported by the Windows 10 operating system. The Spark CPU are mainly used for the server. They are configured for greater data management and data analytical workload with software in silicon technology like the Spark S7 server. This CPU run on Unix-based operating systems such as Solarx by the Sun Microsystem. Ubuntu, on the other hand, have been ported onto to Spark CPU, which allow the operating system to run on the hardware, especially on the Ultra Spark T1 and Ultra Spark T2, chipless by the Open Spark open source community. For Intel Core i7 and AMD, both of these CPU types are supported by both operating system, which is Windows 10 operating system and Ubuntu operating system. The next slide will be OS utilize its processor more efficiency in terms of normal usage and server usage. So under normal usage, we all know that Windows 10 is having a user-friendly interface and greater exposure in the OS market. However, for Ubuntu, user require a basic Linux command knowledge to use the program, and also it is less exposure on the OS market. So under normal usage, is more recommended to be used Windows 10 operating system as is more user friendly as well as well known in public. The next will be under server usage, where Windows 10 is not suitable for using in the server usage is due to it having a heavy GUI processors, which is unnecessary in the usage of server. And the next will be under Ubuntu. Ubuntu is acknowledgement by a large company and it will reduce the unnecessary background application for the server purposes. So under server usage, Ubuntu operating system is much more recommended than Windows 10 operating system.
ม My name is Toa Yong Liang. My ID number is CA19103. Now, I will present the file management in both operating system in Windows and Linux. In Microsoft Windows, files usually are stored in folders on different data drivers like C, D, or E. The naming convention in Windows 10, we usually use / to separate component of a path. This is required as part of volume names, and we do not assume case sensitivity. Volume designators drive letters are similarly case insensitive. After we learn how to name a file in Windows 10, now we continue looking on advantage and disadvantage of system file handling. For the advantage, there are more than 80% of the desktop computers in the world run some sort of Windows operating system. We won't have any trouble to finding hardware and drivers. When we meet the problems in Windows 10, we can easily get the support from online or get the support from the customer service. There are large shareware and freeware application library, so we can easily install what the application that we like. For the computer gamers, Windows 10 is the most widely supported operating system, so they can play many games in Windows 10. For the disadvantage, Windows 10 is the most prone operating system for spyware and virus application, and it is poor security. Other than that, it is also limited access to the library of free open source software. But in Linux, files are ordered in a tree structure starting with the root directory. This root directory can be considered as the start of the file system, and it further branches out various other subdirectories. The root is denoted with a / a general tree file system on your Unix may look like this. The naming convention in Ubuntu, we usually use / and we can mixing the uppercase and lowercase. Incorrectly type file extension is not allowed. The advantage of system file handling in Ubuntu operating system is they are more secure than Windows and other operating system. The operating system is totally free, and we can get the full access to the free open source library of software. While the disadvantage of Ubuntu operating system is the latest and greatest hardware is typically slower to reach to Linux, and is limited vendor support.
Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. Security management in terms of user and password authentication and management for user profile, Windows provide the ability to share one computer among multiple users or for one user to have multiple accounts for different purposes. To do this, each user account is associated with a user profile that describes the way the computer environment looks and operates for that user. This includes the desktop background, desktop content, and Windows color scheme. Whereas it also includes personal and confidential information such as safe password and our internet browsing history. Whereas for Linux, when a new user is created, the adduser utility creates a brand new home directory name /home/username. If our server will be home for multiple users, this means that all users can browse and access the content of other users' home directories. To verify the user's home directory permission, we can use the command ls-ld/home/username. For user account control, Windows, it protects our computer from changes to a Windows system settings. Each area of the Windows interface that requires administrator permission is labeled with a security icon. Whereas for Linux user management, it has a decision to disable the administrator root account by default in all Ubuntu installations. If we wish to enable root account, we can use the command line sudo passwd. Sudo will prompt us for our password and ask us to supply a new password for root. To disable the root account password, we can use the command line sudo passwd -l root. And if we want to read more on sudo, we can use the command line man sudo. For Windows password, it requires three types of characters, which is uppercase or lowercase letter of European languages, base 10 digits, which is 0 through 9, and non-alphanumeric characters. Whereas for Linux, its minimum password length is at least contains 6 characters. In Linux, we have password expirations. It's like a policy to have a minimum and maximum password age, forcing users to change their password when they expire it. In terms of securing kernel from unauthorized access, Windows has Window Defender Smart Screens. It helps protect us from visits, sites that containing malware and stop us from downloading potential malicious files. Windows also has Windows Defender Application Guard. It can protect advanced targeted threats launched against Microsoft Edge using Microsoft Hyper-V virtualization technology. User account control also can protect the user by preventing malware from damaging a machine. It also blocks the automatic installation of unauthorized apps. Windows Defender device also can change from a mode where apps are trusted unless blocked by an antivirus solution to a mode where the OS trusts only apps authorized by an enterprise. Windows Defender Exploit Guard. It includes exploit protection, attack surface reduction rules, network protection, and control folder access. It also provides legacy app protection, including arbitrary code guard, blocking low integrity image, blocking untrusted fronts, and exploit address filtering. Also, BitLocker, it helps by enhancing files and system protections. Windows Defender Credential Guards, it helps to isolate secrets and give a better protections. Whereas for Linux, it reduces installed software. It tests the software that we install and it can remove if we no longer use it. A software package that is not installed can impact our risk. For default deny, this applies to file permission, firewall rules, and access to data. It also can remove identification and application versions. Hiding software banners and version numbers will also stop most automated threat scripts. How the operating system handle an attempt to hack our system from the internet. For Windows, it provides Windows security that will help to protect our PC from screening for malicious software viruses and security threats. It also uses firewalls, keep all software up to date, use antivirus and keep it current. Browse the web safely, which is we must avoid visiting sites that potentially illicit content. Do not open suspicious attachment or click unusual link in message. These usually appear in email, post, tweet, message, attachment, online ads. And sometimes, they discuss themselves as known and trusted source. For Linux, it uses Veracode. Many of these security producers use the same tools that malicious parties abuse in Linux hacking. Veracode cloud-based service and systematic approach deliver a simpler and more scalable solution for reducing global application layer risk across web, mobile, and third-party applications. Veracode is dedicated to help organizations develop and purchase secure applications. With Veracode, companies no longer need to purchase expensive vulnerability assessment software on how to use it and spend time and money constantly updating it.
That's all for our group presenting. Thank you.